Good morning. Welcome to the Boulder Valley Unitarian Universalist Fellowship. I'm Mary Stackpole. My pronouns are she, her. I'm joined today by Service Associate Gloria Perlstein. Today's music is provided by Carmen Sandeem and hymn leader Clara Kelly. And today's tech team is Deborah Minch and Scott Yeomans. And wait, only two members of our tech team? Are you used to hearing three? Yes, we have been short on Zoom hosts lately. And if anyone would like to learn this easy, low time commitment job that helps our services stay more accessible and run smoothly, please contact Deborah Minch at the AV desk after the service or in the Zoom chat. Thanks. I have the honor today of welcoming our new interim minister, Reverend Barbara Queeman, to her first BVUUF service. She will be here in the pulpit in just a couple weeks, but after she settles in. But for today, I'm going to invite her to just come up and give you a quick few words of hello.
Thank you, Mary, so much. Good morning, everyone. I am Reverend Barber. My pronouns are she, her. I am so pleased and honored to be with you all and to be here in person. I've known many of you on screen. It's so good to see you in body. And for folks who are on Zoom, I look forward to meeting you, maybe electronically or in person. I would suggest that our invitation for everyone in the first weeks of this new fellowship year is to get to know one another. And so I will do my best to learn your names, learn your roles here, perhaps learn where you live or other things that you enjoy doing, and maybe during the reception after the service we'll have a chance to speak. Again, I'm so pleased to be here. Thank you for inviting me to serve this interim period. Thank you.
Welcome, Reverend Barbara, and welcome to all of you here today. In all the beauty of languages, cultures, skin tones, shapes and sizes, gifts and challenges that come together in your uniqueness, you are welcome here. In all the ways you experience and express gender, you are welcome here. In all the ways you make your living and the places you are from, you are welcome here. In the beauty that is who you love and how you love, you are welcome here. With all the traditions that inform your spiritual life, you are welcome here today. No matter how long you are away or how soon you will return, you are welcome here. Whether you come with laughter in your heart, or tears, you are welcome here. Whether you find yourself at the beginning of a journey, nearing the end, or if you feel somewhere in between, you are welcome here today. You are invited to join us with a curious mind, a loving heart, and today a spirit of trust and experimentation. We welcome you today. We commit ourselves to being a center for spiritual exploration and justice making and to anti-racism and anti-oppression work, both within and beyond our congregation. If you're new here, we are glad you found us and hope that in this community you can experience the warmth and love of this congregation. Please come back a few times to really get to know us. We have many opportunities during the week for social connection and spiritual growth. Those on Zoom can check out the links in the chat to help you get connected. And those in person are welcome to stop by the welcome table in the foyer for more fellowship information and our newcomer form. Everyone is invited to stay for casual conversation following the service, either on Zoom in the chat or in person in our fellowship hall. If you're joining us on Zoom, please feel free to greet each other in the chat. And for those of you in the sanctuary, Please take a moment to greet your neighbors. Do you want to go ahead and be ready? We love to give you a little preview of how amazing our coffee hour is after the service. So feel free to stay after for more socialization and connection. And now we will light our fellowship chalice. For those of you on Zoom, if you have a chalice at home, you can light it with us as Gloria lights our fellowship chalice. Please say the words along with me as we light our chalice. We light this chalice for the warmth of love, the light of truth, and the energy of action. And now I'll sing our bowl again, inviting it to draw you deeper into the present moment and this, our beloved community. Exactly 1 year ago this week, I had surgery on my left shoulder. As a self-proclaimed and proud gym rat, this may have been one of the harder years of my life. I have spent most of the last 12 months in between injured and able, in between pain and comfort, in between hope and despair, in between strong and very weak, in between confidence and doubt, in between what I was and what I would eventually be. It sucked. I had a lot of anxiety. My mental health suffered. Being between was hard. I knew where I had been and the turns of life that had got me there, and I had a vision of where I would eventually be stronger and healed. But I had to move through the time between, and I couldn't rush it or force it. I wanted so badly to be out of this place that I ignored my body's pleas for rest and recovery, and instead I pushed it to do more. I tried to force it to heal faster. I was determined to be the best physical therapy patient ever seen in the world. At the very least, I was going to do anything I was still able to do to attempt to get back to that before place and feeling of strength and capability. And you know what my body's response was? More pain, more weakness, and many more months in between. I couldn't accept where I was, and I had moments I was certain I would never find the other side, that my shoulder would hurt for the rest of my life. Sometimes I think of it like scooping up a bunch of sand. Instead of holding that sand and myself in the space gently, in open palms, I squeezed my hands desperately together, and those sands leaked right out from beneath between my fingers. As a nation, we find ourselves today in an in-between moment. We are in between the Republican and Democratic conventions. We are in between a known incumbent president and the unknown next president. Some fear we are between democracy and a dangerous slide to autocracy. Likely, this has many of us feeling some of that same anxiety and distress that I experienced in my last year between. And while we all can and should exercise our vote, our right to vote, and participate in the democratic process, come November, we have little individual control over that final outcome. And we are kind of stuck here between. We can't rush the process. We can't get to November any faster. We have to find a way to be in this place. Additionally, our smaller fellowship community is also between. We're between settled ministers. We are entering a 2-year interim ministry with Reverend Barbara. But here's an interesting situation where we have intentionally put ourselves in between. Why would we do that to ourselves? Why didn't we just go from our last settled minister straight to the next? No waiting, no time in between, no anxiety, no uncertainty. Could there possibly be a benefit to being in between? Something to learn or a way to grow? I invite you to keep that question in your mind and hearts throughout our service today. So here we are, in between. What can we do about it? I may not be the one to give advice, considering my somewhat faulty recent year of being between, but perhaps we can all draw on some prior experiences. Can you recall a time that you found yourself between? Between jobs or schools, between relationships, between the first planting of seeds and the zucchini apocalypse. Done with one part of your life, but not quite reached the next. Did you ever notice how the harder you tried to reach that next step, the further away it seemed? And maybe, have you ever had this experience? That the moment when you just stop trying so hard, or you let yourself take a break and take a breath, or you simply accepted the place that you are in, that was the moment when something shifts and your next journey begins.
Well, one good thing about being in between is there's still some comfort here. And music can sometimes be a great source of that. So if you will look in your teal hymnal with me at hymn number 1002, that's 1002. For comfort me, we're gonna get some musical comfort this morning. Yes, if you are feeling it in your body, you may rise. If rest feels right, then rest. Just listen to your body and let's sing together. Sing with me. dance with me. Dance with me. Dance with me. Dance with me, oh my soul. Dance with me. Dance with me. Dance with me, oh my soul. And comfort me. Comfort me.
Good morning. I'm Gloria Perlstein. My pronouns are she and her. We've already heard today about two ways to be between. One, as Mary noted, is to accept the place you're in. A second is music. Music can be a great comfort. When we do accept the place we're in, that often means that we recognize any discomfort that's there. We might have tension in our bodies. We might have emotions that we don't like associated with that in-between place. And it means noticing what we're thinking. Are we expecting the worst? Are we expecting the best? What do we fear? Another thing we can do during times in between is to look for joy and things to laugh about despite any anxiety or discomfort. There's a good reason for that old saying, laughter is the best medicine. Laughter helps us feel more relaxed and lightens our mood, our spirits. Another possibility is to connect and focus on others, not as a way to commiserate or moan about the current situation or uncertainty, but to stay centered in life, to share in each other's joys and sorrows, and to know that we all have our ups and downs. This morning, we're going to experiment with these ways of reacting to the challenges of between times. To do that, we're going to invite you into a between experience, which you may find a little uncomfortable. Okay? Okay. Most of us usually have our cell phones very handy in our pocket or purse. For this experience, we invite you to put some distance between yourself and your phone. And that will be, we'll invite you to bring your phone up to this table that's in the front. Oh, Paul is ready already. No discomfort there. Okay. Wow, it's happening. Let me, wait, there's more. Okay. These are the lead, no. These are the leaders. So, wow, look at this. What? No, I will.
There are more instructions.
There are more instructions, but some people don't need them. So we'll have the early adopters first. All right? Right, right. Well, not everyone has come forward yet.
There we go.
If you are not one of the early adopters here and have some anxiety about doing this, we have some guidelines here. First of all, if you are waiting for an important call, if you're on call at work, no need to bring it up. If you don't have a cell phone, maybe you're one of those very few people now who are not attached to a cell phone, you don't have it with you, okay, no problem there. If you are, however, concerned about your phone, there are a couple of things that you can do to relieve some of that anxiety. One is there are sticky notes on your chairs. You can put your name on that sticky note and put it on your phone and then bring it up. Okay? Yeah. And we, by the way, have a safety volunteer in this congregation. Many of you know Hiram Wolgamoth. And Hiram is here as just a little extra set of eyes and a little extra set of security. Okay. I hope you've turned them off or silenced them before they came up. People on Zoom, there are instructions in the chat for how to do this. And they're still coming. No. Okay. Now, if for one reason or another, you did not bring it up, you feel like you can't do that, you don't want to do that, what I will ask you to do is think of another in-between experience, because that's what we're creating here. This is the time between you're having the phone, bringing it up, and now you're between the time when you brought it up and we'll get it back. And you will get it back shortly after a few more parts of this service. Okay, I think all the phones are in.
Yes.
Remember one of the things I said that is a way to deal with the in-between times, is to look for joy and laughter. I'm going to offer a poem that may bring up some of those feelings. But before I do, just take a moment and just go inside and see, how does this feel to you? How does it feel that you did this? If you're anxious, you may be anxious, you may not. You may feel relieved, you may have whatever, but just pay attention to that feeling. Okay, the poem. And this is based on my own relationship with telephones over the years. This is called Telephones Then and Now. When I was a kid and lived in the sticks, our telephone number was 5416. Those numbers are etched in my mind like a spell. I'll never forget them. They're clear as a bell. And so is the look of our clunky black phone with its rotary dial and shrill ringing tone. We had just one phone in party line mode, a line that we shared with the folks down the road. There were not yet machines that would answer a call, but that didn't bother my family at all. We all knew that if we missed the phone's cry, the person would call back or just come on by. But how things have changed. Now we all have these cells with their customized ringtones like trumpets or bells. And though our devices are little and sleek, they hold way more facts than we need in a week. A world full of knowledge right here in our laps. The internet, weather, podcasts, and maps. They keep us all busy, informed, entertained, with a camera, step counter, and all kinds of games. There's a wide range of music to suit any mood, and Instagram videos on how to make food. Phones help us do chores. We can check in for flights, call up an Uber, or turn out the lights. There are apps upon apps. I've got quite a few. I don't even know what some of them do. No wonder we've gotten attached to our phones. They're modern day miracles, down to their bones. But we may pay a price for the gifts that they bring by losing perspective about a few things. Because of their speed, we may stop being fans of longer, more thoughtful attention spans. Our patience may also suffer a blow if we start feeling bored because life seems too slow. And focusing too much upon that small screen may keep us from seeing what's here to be seen. So let's look at all sides now and see if this rest from our greatly loved cell phones might help relieve stress.
We all came here today with our phones tucked safely away in pockets and purses, And I promise we'll all leave here in the same manner. But for now, here we are in between. And I have to say, of all of the reactions we went through in our heads planning this, the eagerness was not one we counted on. So perhaps if this is, you know, bringing in some of those harder between feelings, check in with those. If this was like a huge relief to you, maybe bring up one of those in-between moments in your life and feel those feelings too, and just check in with your body and how you're feeling. And did any of those feelings, did any of that weight lift as you listened to Gloria's poem and maybe giggled in your head or out loud? It was a lovely poem. Did you forget for a moment that your phone was up here? It is still here if you want to stand up and peek. They haven't gone. They haven't grown legs and walked away. We're good. Laughter has a beautiful way of helping us be present in difficult between times. Another useful tool is mindfulness. We can practice mindfulness in prayer, meditation, yoga, or walking, best without your phones, walking without your phones. Or anything that allows our mind to calm, our thoughts to slow, and our spirits to center. So I'd like to invite you now to join me in a little visualization. If you'd like, you can let your eyes close, or you can also just let them soften without focusing on any one thing. Imagine with me that you are on a road trip. You've left home and are headed somewhere fun and exciting. You can't wait to get there. But you have an 8-hour drive first. You start your drive feeling ready. You've got your favorite playlist. You've told yourself there'll be some cool scenery along the way. And you are feeling those road trip vibes. Now, fast forward an hour. Has it really only been an hour? Surely it's been longer than that. And then your playlist stops. You're out of service and you forgot to download it. Ugh! There goes your music. Silence fills the car. But that's okay, you tell yourself. Remember, the scenery. We're going to look at the scenery. You see a large sign up ahead, and it's got a big arrow on it, and you wonder what interesting roadside attraction it might be pointing you to. You get closer and closer, and you see the vague outline of some sun-faded letters, but just as you are close enough to make them out, zoom, you zip right on by. Dang, you missed it. As you look out at the long, empty, straight road ahead, you think, maybe you can make this go by faster. So you gently press that pedal down and your speed creeps up. 80, 90, 100, whoo! You feel the exhilaration, excitement of knocking some hours off of this journey. But then suddenly you see a black vehicle ahead on the side of the road, and you quickly lift your foot from the pedal, and the car lurches back as it drastically slows. And as your heart tries to leap from your chest, you pass the vehicle just a tad over the limit and realize it wasn't a cop, just an abandoned car. Whew! You tell yourself maybe pushing the speed wasn't worth the near heart attack. So now what? No tunes, no making the drive go any faster by speeding, stuck on the road for many more hours between where you were and where you're going. You take a deep breath. You wiggle into a bit more of a comfortable position in your seat. You feel the vibrations of the road throughout your body. As your breathing calms and slows, you notice it. You notice your chest rising and falling. You let your eyes soften enough to still watch the road, but allow the scenery to whisk on by without trying to grasp it in your vision. Sights come slowly into your peripheral vision, and you notice them, and then they pass by. Your grip on the steering wheel relaxes. You feel a sense of calm come over you, and you sink into it. You breathe in. You breathe out. And then, before you know it, you've arrived.
We've arrived at our sacred time of community sharing. This is the time to express personal joys and concerns. Please save gratitudes and announcements for another time. And today, let's view this beloved practice as a chance to experience how deeply listening to others can center us in the present, even when we're in between times. So if you're on Zoom and you'd like to share a joy or concern, please type it into the chat window and let us know briefly what's in your heart today, and I will read aloud what you share. If you're in the sanctuary, you can come up front, share your joy or concern using the microphone, and add a stone to our sacred waters, or you can add a stone in silence. And Mary, could you put in a stone for all affected by the wildfires here in Colorado, in California, in the Northwest, and in Canada? And one last stone for any joys and concerns that remain in the silent sanctuary of our hearts, knowing that even in our silence, we are bound together in the web of life. Spirit of love and life, thank you for this chance to be together today. May those whose hearts are heavy find comfort. May those with joyful hearts remain glad. And may we each be a blessing to each other and to the world around us, which so urgently needs our care. Blessed be. And now it's time to reunite with your phone. Just in time for the offering, of course. Please just come up and retrieve your phone. Let's take a little time. Don't rush people as they're coming up. It may take some time to recognize and find your phone.
And if you're on Zoom, this is the time to retrieve your phone if you'd like to. Two phones are looking for their people. Okay. Yes. Okay. Okay. Now that everyone is reunited with your phone, just take a moment to talk with the person next to you about how this experience was for you. Just take a few seconds. How did you feel? How was it? Oh, yeah. Yeah,
it should. It was surprising.
No, me neither. No, me neither. It did. So.
Give him a minute and ring the bell.
Yeah. I haven't been watching the time, but I think.
Thank you for your spirit of trust and experimentation. Hopefully we all got a little snippet of something out of that. Each week here, we remind ourselves of the abundance of our lives and this community by giving away half our plate to those organizations that share our values, with our current emphasis on food insecurity. Each week this month, the half plate will be going to Community Food Share and their different programs. Community Food Share is a food bank fighting hunger in Boulder and Broomfield counties by providing access to fresh, nutritious food through its on-site and mobile pantries, as well as through partnering with more than 40 nonprofit organizations. and they also advocate for policies to create long-term solutions to hunger. You can text your donation at the number on the screen, or if you're at the fellowship today, place a donation in the offering plate as it passes. Please give generously, as you so often do. And as our musical reflection begins, we invite you to reflect upon more, or perhaps write in the chat for those on Zoom, your answer to the question, what's the major takeaway from this cell phone experience today? For the work of the fellowship, bringing love, reason, justice, and compassion to the world, and for community food share, we dedicate these offerings. We have just a couple of quick announcements, and I'd first like to invite Clara up to the podium to share an announcement.
Hello. So our church, BVUUF, is part of the Welcoming Congregations group in the Unitarian Universalist Association. What that means is that we work as a congregation to make sure that our fellowship is a safe and comforting place for LGBTQIA folks. And that actually does take work. It isn't just an attitude, it actually takes educating ourselves, right? And I know that a lot of you have already listened to the podcast. Thank you to the 21 people who have already listened. But I need about 29 more to listen so that we can get recertified this year. It's not an easy listen. If you are a trans person, you don't need to listen to this podcast. You already know all of this because it is about how trans folk are being targeted in politics, especially trans children. However, if you are cisgender, meaning not trans, if you would please take the time to listen to this, it's like 30, 40 minutes. You know, put it on when you're on a drive or at home when you get time. And once you do listen to it, could you please let me know? The best way to do that is to email me. You can tell me in person, and I'll stick around afterwards the service today if you want to just tell me. But email is fantastic because then I have a record of it so I can go back and double check my numbers. The QR for the podcast is here. And if you just want the link, you can always email me and I'll just shoot you the link, no problem, if that's easier for you. Thank you for your time and work on this. We find that it's important for us to put in the work to make our place safe for everyone. You can email me for the link, or you can hold up your phone and it'll pop up on your phone if you grab this QR code. Yeah.
Do we know if it's on the website? It was in connections. Okay. We'll get everyone connected with the link in one way, shape, or form. The last announcement, Robin gave us a beautiful preview that after this service, we have a chance to celebrate our welcome for Reverend Barbara. There will be cake provided by the board. And again, there will be those little note cards for you to leave a suggestion of your favorite haunts around the area. So Reverend Barbara has some ideas to try. Yes.
There's also coffee Q&A after the service.
Thank you. Coffee Q&A after the service back in the sanctuary.
UGUU or not, has questions about this fellowship or UGUU, come get your coffee and come back here.
Thank you. In case you couldn't hear, go get your coffee. Come back to the sanctuary, a coffee Q&A. If you are new to UU or have been a UU but have any questions about what that means and what that is, there will be a discussion after the service. Thank you, Lucy. And we have one more hymn to share.
Should have just come up here, I forgot. All right. Woyaya is a great song about not being there yet. If you know it, you can just sing along if you want to look at it. It's in your teal hymnal, number 1020 or 1020. It's a plenty long song, so we're just going to sing it all the way through one time, okay? Oh yeah, and again, if your body is feeling it, you can rise. If not, that's okay too.
We are going, heaven knows where we are going, but we know within, and we will get there. Heaven knows how we will get there, but we know we will. It will be hard, we know, and the road will be muddy and rough, but we'll get there. Heaven knows how we will get there, but we know we will. Woyaya, 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 woyaya. We are going, heaven knows where we are going, but we know within.
Woyaya, 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 woyaya. And now we will extinguish our fellowship chalice. As Gloria extinguishes it, please say the words along with me. We extinguish this chalice, but not the warmth of love, the light of truth, nor the energy of action. These we carry in our hearts until we meet again. As we close our service, I invite you to stand. You are welcome to hold hands or link arms if that feels welcome to you today. And I'd like to share a poem by Morgan Harper Nichols. Let July be July, and let August be August, and let yourself just be, even in uncertainty. You don't have to fix everything. You don't have to solve everything. And you can still find peace and grow in the wild of changing things. Namaste and blessed be.